That's a weird bit of music. Now, here's a game that made an impact on the Amiga. Well, I don't remember this particular bit of music. I'm wondering how it's translated over to the Mega Drive. They already seem to be over-egging the pudding. There was no need for all of this. Yeah. I don't like that. I just want that understated intro, you know, from the Amiga. That's all this. Really? From the Diary of Lester Knight Chaykin, is that his name? I don't know that's his name. I'm using a period of rest to record some information. Do we want to go through this? No, come on, let's skip this. I want to see that intro, though. Are we going to get it now? No, we... Oh, my goodness, we just don't get it. Swim, 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 swim. B button, B button. That thing is faster than it looks. Right. Oh, it's smaller than I remember it. Okay, that's run. That's kick. We need kick. See, kick is all... Oh, no, that was run. Hang on. It's a one-button control. I think if you press run... I think if you press the button while you're moving, he runs. Ah, swim, 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 swim. Okay, so you've got to tap B or A button, by the looks of it. Let's get out the water and see what's what. If I stay still, though, I think I get got. So we've got that. Ah, okay, we've got jump and another button. So A and B both do the same thing. C jumps. Now, it's not as nice as the Amiga version. I don't know why yet. I haven't quite put my finger on it. So this little kick thing I'm doing, the sound doesn't help. The sound's not great. Alright, same button for kick and run, which is a bit of a pain, so you've got to stop before you kick. That's kind of true to the Amiga version, fair enough. There was only one button on that. Uh-oh, watch your head, watch your head. The nasty little things. They look so innocent. I'm not going. I'm not doing it. Come on. Let's have you. Nasty little slug beasts. Right. Now, if I remember correctly, monster. Oh, yeah. And run. Do I need to jump or will it jump for me? That's the thing. We don't know yet. I might get eaten. Whoa, he falls. I knew that was coming. I played this before. Okay, we're going to try jumping at the end of this. Ready? And jump. Oh, no. I didn't press it quick enough. I got proper chomped. Please don't go back to the water. Oh, man. Yeah, this was the thing with Another World. Every time you make decent progress, you get a password, which is cool. It works. But it does mean that there's a lot of going back and doing bits again. Oh, it's so slow, this bit. I always hated this bit because it was hard to get into like a rhythm of kicking the little dudes. And there's loads on this bit. That little sting on his tail, you can see it. I mean, nasty. Uh-oh, watch your head, watch your head, watch your head. Yeah, now there's two in that little lump of slugness. Just gotta keep tapping that little kick button. Oh, there's one behind me. He's probably going to stay there when I run, so I better clear the path. I have now made that species extinct. Or at least that family. And we're off. Okay, now we've got to jump and we've got to time it right. The problem is, I'm not entirely sure where the timing is. On the Amiga version, I think it just jumped for you because there's only one button. On this version, there's a jump button. There we go. And jump. Yes. And now, I think we pull back or does it do it for you? There we go. Now we've got to run again. Run again. Oh, man, he's coming. He's coming. He's a coming. There he is. Oh, God. Oh, run. Oh, no. Oh, no, he's going to get me. Where is he? There he is. I knew that was going to happen. I played it before. Rescued by a dude. Hey, dude. He doesn't look friendly, does he? He certainly didn't. Two unfriendly dudes. And one not so unfriendly dude. See, this is where cutscenes really work without any dialogue or any particular detail to them. We know exactly what transition there. Cut to, you are now in prison. It tells you everything you need to know in a very simple, easy to follow manner. And I love that. Now, that's me, obviously, in the cage. And as you can see, the guy is leaning left to right. The reason is, I am doing that on the pad. And the way out of this cage is to swing it. He's not happy. Uh-oh. And he's called his mates. He's really not happy. It's all academic, really, cos have that. Okay. Oh, gun. Maduba. I think that was thank you. Yeah, we'll take that. Thanks very much. Now, let's see if we can figure it out. Okay. Press it and you shoot. Tap it and you shoot. Press it a bit longer and you've got a shield. Okay. And I think you press it longer still and you've got a bigger shield now. Yeah, okay. I'm going to die a few times here, I think, before I get this right. But I'm going to put a shield down there. I'm going to get behind that shield. Oh, he's put a shield down, has he? Well, I put two shields down. I see your shield and raise your shield. Now, what are you going to do now? Oh, no, I walked past the shield. HTDC. Can we just... Yeah, we can just go back to it. Oh, we've got to swing the thing again. Swinging the thing. Okay. Yeah, it's pretty close to the Amiga. The sound effects are nowhere near as nice. And it all feels smaller. Well, that's clearly because I'm playing it in the little 640, 480 window. Altered Beast felt small earlier on. And everything's feeling small in this window. You got to remember, when you're playing this on like a Mega Drive or an Amiga, you're playing it on like a massive telly. Or, you know, a portable telly. But a telly, and it fills the full screen. And it looks really nice. Because it gets all softened by the CRT monitors, you know. And it's different. It's not so pixelated. It's not so small. Yeah, pick the gun up. And we lose that when we're emulating stuff. I remember showing it off on YouTube. We lose that. So just bear that in mind. The context has changed a little. I like all the little dudes in the foreground. These little touches that you don't necessarily need to employ are charm. They make the game charming. You didn't need to put that detail in. You did. For the love of it. And that's charming. Right, I think we can go. Oh, I see. We've got a big door to shoot. Oh no, behind us. Oh, this is proper Star Wars. So, a couple of shields. Oh, he's just opened it. Quick, run! Okay, up the lift. Oh no, wait for the dude. No, wait for the dude. Which way are we going? We can go up or down. I can't remember. Let's go up. Let's go down. I like the little sparkly effect. I loved all that, that sort of Delphine spark. That was the intro to this game was full of that. And I was dying to see it again. But hey, it's there somewhere if you get through the boring... what was it? Diary sequence. Okay. You hold this gun a little bit longer and we get that. Oh, he's heard us. He's on to us. Oh no, I don't like that. If we just drop down there, we'll be dying instantly. Should we find out? That walk's a lot slower than I remember being. There's no need for that. Oh, really? Have we got to do this quietly then? Ah, we're back there. Okay, I'm going to call that me 10 minutes. Awesome game. Not a bad port. A good port of an awesome game. Another World on the Sega Mega Drive. Definitely worth a play. Thanks for watching.